medicine all around is always very humbling, any kind of skill you may fail at. And this provides you with a, let me relook and retry in a different safe environment. And when I go to the patient, I might be more optimal.
There need to be a level of competence. And we can provide that with simulation. It has now been 21 years after we opened the initial skills lab.
That history has been brought forward as a result of the strong push to ensure that students are able to train in safe and protected environments.
This space boasts state-of-the-art teaching venues equipped with interactive whiteboards, room cameras, as well as tilt zoom cameras to capture high definition videos.
The definition of high fidelity would be that you are allowing the learner to immerse themselves into a realistic situation, and that's where our manikins come to play.
You can practice intubation, so then you'll have a head with lungs that you can practice putting the tubes into the correct place.
The manikins can react to a drug that is being given. They can change their vital signs, what we call their blood pressure, their respiration rate, etc., etc.
And it also reduces the performance anxiety that our young medical students usually have.
And the confidence has been built because I get numerous sessions to actually come and practice the skills.
I think one of my favorite things about the Skills Lab is having the opportunity to practice real life-saving emergency procedures in an environment where we won't compromise ourselves or the patients.
But the big part of learning in simulation actually takes part in debriefing. It's got to be a safe environment.
Medicine and clinical medicine is not just about making a diagnosis, it is the way that you speak to the patient, the way that you obtain a history, and also the way that you convey diagnosis and often bad news.
One of the methods that we commonly use is peer-assisted learning for the training of clinical skills for our junior undergraduate medical students. This method is very effective in that it's mutually beneficial for both the student learners and the student teachers.
Now that I've started with clinical practice, I can see the full value that the Skills Lab has provided me with. The simulation experience has given me tremendous confidence in the real-life clinical situations.
So we look forward to this very exciting journey that we're on and to changing and shifting the way in which health professions education takes place here at the Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences.